Oh, hi. Humans have done some pretty cool things in space. We've been to the moon. No, trolls, we have. We really have been to the moon. We've built the ISS, the permanently manned space station, whizzing around the Earth every 90 minutes or so. And in the next 30 years, NASA and SpaceX plan to send the first humans to Mars. Other space agencies are available. But with deadly cosmic and solar radiation, space sickness and muscle wastage, it's not going to be easy on our bodies. And no one knows for sure how they will cope on such a long mission. So instead of sending human guinea pigs into this hostile environment, why don't we first send actual guinea pigs? Should we send animals to Mars? Animals have been used in aeronautic exploration as early as 1783, when the Montgolfier brothers sent a sheep, a duck, and a rooster aloft in a hot air balloon. Skip forward to the end of World War II, and things were about to be taken to a whole new level, quite literally, as the race for space dominance began with the holy grail of sending people to the moon. Whilst Russia used dogs like Laika, famous for being the first animal to orbit the Earth, the US primarily used monkeys to propel their research forward, as their physiology is so similar to our own. In January of 1961, the US deployed one of its most famous animal astronauts. His name was simply Number 65, a 3-year-old chimpanzee that had been extensively training for almost 2 years, vital as this mission was unlike any other. Under the direction of neuroscientist Joseph V. Brady, Number 65 had to do simple, timed tasks in response to electric lights and sounds. In his pre-flight training, Number 65 was taught to push a lever within 5 seconds of seeing a flashing blue light. Failure to do so resulted in an application of negative reinforcements in the form of a mild electric shock to the soles of his feet, while a correct response earned him a banana pellet. On January 31st, 1961, Number 65 was secured in a Project Mercury mission labeled MR2 and launched from Cape Canaveral in Florida on a suborbital flight. During the flight, the capsule suffered from a partial loss of pressure, but thankfully, Number 65's spacesuit prevented him from suffering any harm. The clever chimp performed his tasks exactly as practiced, with his lever-pushing performance only a fraction of a second slower than that on Earth, demonstrating that tasks could be performed comfortably in space. After a brief but intense flight of just over 16 minutes, his capsule splashed down in the Atlantic Ocean and was recovered by a rescue ship later that day. Unlike many of his contemporaries, Number 65 was found in good health and only suffered a bruised nose. It was only at this point, on his safe return, that Number 65 was given the name that he is known by today, Ham. Reportedly because officials didn't want the bad press that would come from the death of a named chimpanzee if the mission were a failure. What differentiates Ham's mission from all the other primate flights to this point is that he was not merely a passenger. The results from his test flight were incredibly insightful and led directly to the mission that Alan Shepard made on May the 5th, 1961, aboard Freedom 7, to become the second man and the first American in space. The story of Ham is a prime example of how animals have helped us achieve our goals in space. But surely science has moved forward enough now that we don't need to send animals anymore. Well, for short-term trips, yes, it's hard to see the benefits. But for longer ones, like a 7-month-long trip to Mars, require a lot more research, as just getting there alone would be longer than any human has ever spent in space at one time. And the human body is very complex. Not all studies can be carried out in a petri dish. So, like it or not, The fact is, using animals is still one of the best scientific ways to study how the human body will react on such a trip. And so, as a result, animal experimentation continues today. For example, in 2010, NASA planned to expose squirrel monkeys to harmful levels of radiation to simulate the radiation that humans might feel on long-duration journeys in space. The experiments were cancelled after huge protests, but still. In 2013, Iran sent a grey rhesus monkey into space. Their reasons aren't even that clear, but it would appear that it was more a show of technological know-how than for any real scientific purposes. In 2016, NASA sent mice up to the ISS for more experiments, never to return, at least not alive. And if all of that isn't controversial enough, in 2015, reports surfaced that researchers from the Russian Academy of Science were training four macaque monkeys for the long-distance trek to Mars. But maybe you think that's okay. After all, animals have helped us make major leaps forward in space exploration, and space exploration helps us make major leaps forward in technology and us better understanding the planet. And if that eventually leads to us taking better care of the Earth and all its inhabitants, then perhaps we've got to make some sacrifices along the way. Or maybe, like me, you think that we've just got to find other methods, even if that means slower progress. Ham the chimpanzee was lifted to the status of hero, but I don't think that he was a hero. Heroes make their own decisions and choose to risk their own lives to further their cause. Ham didn't risk his own life to further space exploration. He never had a choice. But what do you think? Should we send animals to Mars? Is it ever right to exploit animals for human gains? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. And hit that bell so you know whenever I upload a new video. I've been Dom, and you've been watching Everything.